Na ninaongoza kama nimeokoka na nashukuru Mungu kwa ajili ya neema, and I'm also humbled before our Rev even in his absentia and our pastor even for giving me the chance to lead today's service. And I welcome you all to this service. Together with those who are watching us online, you are all welcome, and we know that the Lord has a plan for us. So let us believe and pray so that we may start together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we humble before your presence this evening, O God. Lord, we thank you because we have gathered in your house that we may have time with you, O Father. We thank you because you've been together with us. We thank you because you've been merciful to us. And we thank you because even you've made us be here today, O God. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you even for assembling us here with a purpose, O God. Lord, we thank you because you never gather your people in vain. And we thank you because today, O Lord, our lives will be transformed by you, Jehovah, Lord. In this moment, Father, we give ourselves unto you, Jehovah, Lord, that you may have your way in our hearts, O God. We give ourselves and surrender before you that we may receive your word, O God. Thank you for everyone that is in this place, O Father, even for those who are still on the way and those who are watching us online, my Father. We pray the Lord you may continue teaching us, O God, even your ways, O Father. You may continue lifting our lives, O God, and even today, my Father, our lives will not remain the same, O Father. Lord, we decrease that you will increase today, the Lord your will alone will prevail in this place, O God. Thank you, Lord, because you have a reason that you made us be here today with the knowledge that you are the one that controls everything, O Father. You are the one that made us be here today, and we believe and trust in you, O God, that even as we continue fellowshipping, O Father, and even as we continue having time in your presence, Jehovah God, you will continue helping our lives and you'll continue changing us, O God, until we become the people that, Lord, you desire us to be, O Father. We surrender everything before you, our worship, O God, even the testimonies of your people, my Father, and even your word, O God. We thank you because your word is life, O Father, and we thank you because as we receive your word, our lives will not remain the same, O God. We pray that our hearts will be devoted to you, O God. We pray that, Lord, we will humble before you. I pray that Jesus will help us even to surrender to you, Jehovah God, and I pray even for our hearts, O God, that when your word comes to us, my Father, it will have a place in us, O God. We surrender and submit before you, Jehovah, that as you continue teaching us, Jehovah, we shall listen, O God, and we shall be followers of your word, my Father. We give all unto you, O Father, praying that you may take over and reign in this place, O God. We love you, Jesus, and we love to have a fellowship with you, my Father. We even pray for your Holy Spirit to be upon us in this meeting, my Father, because it is your presence and your Holy Spirit, O God, that makes the whole difference, O God. We welcome your spirit to reign. We welcome your presence to be with us in the name of Jesus Christ. Even we pray that you sanctify us, Jehovah God. We pray that even as we lift our hands in worship, even as we call unto you, Jehovah, we will offer acceptable sacrifices before you. We worship you, Lord, and submit before you in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Praise Jesus. Yeah, ni siku ingine njema na hii wiki, and poleni sana, ningependa you just say hi to your neighbor, umkaribishe katika ibada ya siku ya leo, na ni vizuri hata umulize, what are you hungry for nowadays? Muulize tu, what are you hungry for nowadays? You know, squeezy watu, kuna watu wana they are hungering for, you know, positions, for material things. Ni vizuri unamuuliza, what are you hungering for? What are you hungry for? What are you desiring? Ni nini huo unasikia tu uko na kiu na njaa yake? Kama hajamkwambia if the person does not tell you he's hungering for righteousness, ama kama hajakwambia ana kiu na tamaa na Mungu, hebu muulize, have you tasted God? Ni vizuri muulize, kama hajakwambia he's hungry for God nowadays, muulize kama ame taste. Have you tasted of the Lord? Have you tasted of the Lord? Amen. Hii wiki tumekuwa tukijifunza ama tumekuwa tukiongozwa pia na theme ya wiki imekuwa hunger for righteousness that results in kingdom work. And when I was thinking about hunger, I was also closely connecting with craving. Okay, I don't know whether there's another word what a craving, but hunger is that desire for something. And craving pia closely related to hunger ni hiyo tamaa ya kitu ama desire ya kitu. And if for instance I'm craving for Fanta passion, even if you give me Fanta orange or you give me Coke, I will not feel satisfied. Sindio? I will still feel like I've not taken what my heart wants. And this week, as we've been learning about hunger and thirst for righteousness, and I was just seeing that if we are not living right, it's like nisisi tumeamua, because the Lord has already made provisions for us. He has already given us that blessing. And tulikuwa tunasoma in the book of Matthew 5. And ukianza hata before ufike verse 6. In Matthew 5, the Bible says that Jesus had alikuwa amefuatwa na a multitude. Watu wengi sana walikuwa wamemfuata. And akapanda mahali, akaanza kuwapea the natango wa beatitudes. Akaanza kuwahubiria. And this was among the most and the greatest sermons za Yesu, and it's like he was giving them the way. Praise God. Alikuwa anataka anawaambia, blessed are the righteous, for they shall be. Kwani hatusomi Biblia? Okay. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be. Hiyo si tunajua, for they shall be comforted. So it's like Jesus was giving them the way. In the book of now Matthew 5:6, the Bible was saying that blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be fulfilled. Bonasifiwe. So if someone has that hunger and that desire for righteousness, then they will be fulfilled. All we need to do is to just appear before him, is to just be open to God and tell the Lord, you see, I am this and I'm going through this, I'm having this issue, I desire to, you know, to live right, I desire to do things in the right way, because I know at times, even in our businesses and in our workplace, we know maybe there's a procedure that has been given for a certain thing, but at times you find unakosa kufuata the right procedure. And the Lord is reminding us that blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be fulfilled. So whatever desire that we have in our heart, even as I welcome the praise team, that we may have a moment of prayer, that everything that we desire, every way that we desire to walk in, the Lord has already even supplied his grace, that we may walk according to his way, that blessing that is connected to righteousness, we will receive it. At times we may feel like when we are being told do the right thing, you know, do this, do that, we may feel like it's like tunakuwa limited, but the Lord wants us to enjoy the freedom that has no end. Praise the Lord. Because if we hunger for righteousness, that means we will continually seek his kingdom. And the Bible says that you seek first his kingdom and his righteousness. Then the things that we are running after, the things that everyone in this world is running after, they will be things that will be added unto us. We will not be hungering for, you know, positions. We will not be looking after positions. We will not be chasing things. But the things that we see that they are so important in our lives, they will be added unto us. So even as we stand, We are going to pray as we tell God that he may help us, he may deposit in us that desire for him, the desire for righteousness, that we may taste of him, that we may have him in our hearts, that we may have a continuous desire, not a desire that we come for one day and then the next minute it is not there. We pray that that desire for righteousness, the desire for God, that desire for him, it will not dry in our lives in the name of Jesus. As the deer panted for the waters, as the deer just looked for a stream to take water, so should our souls be. As David was praying, that as the deer panted for the waters, so my soul longs after thee. So as we pray, just tell the Lord that he may help you, he may help us all in the name of Jesus Christ.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We are here before you, my Father, for there is none like you, my Redeemer. Jioni ya leo ni mfalme wa falme na hakuna mwingine kama yeye Yesu. Thank you, everlasting Father, for you are the King of Kings. Baba, jioni ya leo hakika Bwana, bila upendo wako mtakatifu, hakika Bwana, tunahitaji ukatuwezeshe, tunahitaji ukatuongoze katika njia zako Bwana. Nena na Mungu, ambia Mungu, ongea na Mungu wako jioni ya leo. Tell God that Jehovah, you are in his presence this evening. Tell God that you are in his presence this evening, in the mighty name of Jesus. For he is able, for he is mighty, for he is worthy, in the mighty name of Jesus. There is none like you, our Redeemer. There is none like you, our Father. You are able, my Redeemer. There is no one like you, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father, for you are mighty. Even as we bow down before you, my God, we need you, O Lord, to guide us. We need your Spirit to guide us, O my Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my God. Thank you, Jesus. See, Jonah, come away. See, Japata, tena come away. Akutakuwa. Kutakuwepo wakuabudiwa ni wewe peke. Sijaona Mungu kama wewe. Sijapata tena kama wewe. Akutakuwa, akutakuwepo wakuabudiwa ni wewe peke. Sijaona,
sijaona Mungu kama wewe.
Sijapata,
sijapata tena kama wewe.
Oh,
hakutakuwa,
oh,
hakutakuwepo wa kuabudiwa
Yahwe.
Oh,
si jaona,
sijapata. Sijapata tena kama wewe. Hakujakuwepo wa kuabudiwa. Ni wewe peke. Sijaona kama wewe. Sijapata kena kama wewe. Hakujakuwa hakujakuwepo wa kuabudiwa. Sijapata
tena kama wewe.
Hakujakuwa kuwa ila ni wewe Yesu. You are worthy of our praise, O Lord. Oh my Redeemer, hakuja kuwa mfalme, ulikuweko na bado uko Bwana. Thank you Jesus, for there is no one like you, my Redeemer. My Father, there is none like you, my Redeemer. Lord, you are worthy of our praise, O Lord. You are worthy of our praises, O Lord. In your praises, O my Father, my Redeemer, it is all about you, my Father. O Lord Jehovah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. Wastahili wewe Bwana. 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 Kupokea
utukufu, oh, wastahili.
Asante, manona staili, wastaili by mioyo yetu. Thank you, everlasting. Thank you, my Redeemer, for there is no one like you, my Father. Wastaili, wastaili. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Thank you, my Father. In the name of Jesus, God, we pray, trust, and believe in it. Thank you, Jehovah.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Najua kuna baridi kidogo, but tutaenda kumsifu Bwana siku ya leo. Kidogo tu.
Bwana Bwana ainuliwe ametenda mema. Oh, ametenda mema.
celebrate Jesus for his goodness. He is good and gracious to us, and he is faithful. Praise the Lord. He has made you and me together in this place so that we can hear what he has for us in the name of Jesus. We have a new theme that is leading us in this week. That is hunger for righteousness that leads to kingdom works. Praise the Lord. Something that Paul said in the book of Philippians from chapter 3 from verse 8, that he has counted all things that were beneficial to him and counted them as dung so that he can gain the excellency of Christ. He says from verse 9, not so that it may be count for me on my own righteousness which is by law, but that which is found by faith in Christ Jesus. Praise the Lord. And I was thinking of what is happening. Paul had everything. When he's starting that scripture, he's speaking of how he used to do things. He speaks of himself. He was a Jew of Jews. He had gone under the law of Gamaliel. So everything that was required in their times, in their age, in that community, he had it. That, or rather, hiyo experience ya mambo ambayo ni a religion, he had this, because even in persecuting the Christians, he was not doing it because he was a sinner. He was doing it to fulfill their own religion. Praise the Lord. And one thing I was thinking, I thought about something that happened yesterday. And so many people are celebrating to see the people who are being called the Gen Z's trending. Praise the Lord. I know probably ukiwa mchanga ama ukiwa kijana umeona hayo mambo, that even they are trending just because they went to the streets to oppose. Even some don't have some understanding of what they are opposing. Praise the Lord. And at times people are celebrating them because of that. And I ask myself, how are we sisi ambao ni wa Kristo ambao tunaweza itwa hata hiyo Gen Z ama hata sisi ambao ni wazee? What are we celebrating, or what we can we be celebrated for? We are speaking of the hunger for righteousness. Can we be celebrated? Or if we have to be celebrated, we can make it within our lives as a thing that we shall follow. If we have to be celebrated, let us be celebrated because of how we sought God. Praise God. Let us be celebrated. Let people see us trending because of how we pursued God and his righteousness. If there are things people to see about us or to speak about us that happened in our generation, that happened in our times, let them say that those people loved God, not that those people went to the street to oppose a finance bill. Praise the Lord. Because some things are just for a temporal, or they are just for a temporal moment. But there is that thing which is permanent that cannot be denied or cannot be taken from you. And there is that thing that we usually sing, that reunemenyete ota zakayo. I have known as Zacchaeus that there is something precious more than all other things. And whoever has that thing, akona benefit because amewekewa taji biguni. Praise the Lord. And this evening, tell God, even as we await to hear the word of God, that Lord, if I have to be known, let it be known that I loved you, God. If I have to be known in this world, if people have to know me, let them not know me because of the wrong reasons, but let them know that I sought you, God, that I loved you, in the name of Jesus. The things that we see, the Bible says they are temporal, but there are things which are eternal, that has an eternal value that we can seek for, that we can look for, that we can hunger for, that we can seek in the name of Jesus. Paul realized that something that he held so much dear, he had to let it go. for him to gain the excellency that is found in Christ Jesus. There are things in our lives probably we hold so dear, and at times we need to hold them, to let them go, so that we can gain the excellency that is found in Christ Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, there is fame that many desire fame, but fame is just for a moment. Many desire to be celebs, but being a celeb is just for a moment. But there is something that we can have in our lives that has an eternal value. In the name of Jesus, having a right standing with our God, having a right standing with our Father, that will lead our lives even to desiring to work for him. In the name of Jesus Christ, I give you glory, I give you honor. In the name of Jesus Christ, I will not seek for temporal things, but Lord, I'll be there to seek you in all your fullness. In the name of Jesus, in your fullness, in the name of Jesus. Even as we go to hear the word of God, you can tell the Lord that even to your generation, to your children, they shall be found not seeking things which are of temporal value, but they shall be found seeking things that have eternal value. In the name of Jesus, oh God, we bless you. We give you glory. We give you honor, because you shall enable our lives. In the name of Jesus, we will not just be found looking for things that are just for a moment, but Lord, we shall be found seeking you in your totality. In the name of Jesus, I'll tell you.
You are all I want. You are all I've ever needed. You are all I want. Help me know you. Sing, draw me close to you, Lord. Draw me close to you. Never let me go. Never let me go. Rain on down again. Oh, do you say that I'm a friend? Oh, you are my desire. You are my desire. And no one else will do. No one else will do. Nothing else can take the place to feel the warmth of your embrace, to feel the warmth of your embrace. Oh, help me find a way, help me find your way, bring me back to you.
We give you praise, we worship you. Open your mouth and worship you. Halada selaria dabasola bia kadabashalia. Eladia shadagari bahazalia dabashadagara busari adaba. You are all I want. You are all I ever needed. Eladaya salabagada basura begadaya. Draw me near to you, Jehovah. Do not let me go again. Bend my heart towards you, Master. Heladaya ladaya labosilihada bababosa dagadea. Righteousness, righteousness is what I long for tonight. Halada silabababa. Righteousness is all what I need tonight. Helada sadabagada busala. Righteousness is all what you want for me. Righteousness, O God. Righteousness. Holiness. Laya salabahadebo saliada. Brokenness. Legeda isolabiada bagada. Take my heart and mold it. Take my heart and mold it. Take my will. Conform it to yours. Take my mind and transform it. Ladaya solabahanda. We are here for a night of transformation. Holy Spirit, we wait on you. Elaya salabake salabaya kasiliya dabasola. Righteousness. 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 In Jesus' name, Hadebo Sakadagada. Titus chapter number 2, verses number 11 and 12. One prayer point, then we sit down. Yelada Seda. New King James Version. Elobiya Sokarabaya Salagaria. Titus chapter number 11, verses chapter number 2, verse number 11 and 12. One prayer point, then we sit down. One, two, three, let us read it together, church. Make it louder in the name of Jesus Christ. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. And this grace, what does it do? Verse 12. Make it louder. Teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present age. Say, in this present age. Hallelujah. There is a grace tonight. And this grace, it is teaches us to say no to unrighteousness, to say no to ungodly things in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift your hands, open your mouth and tell God you need this grace to rest upon you tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. This grace will enable you to live soberly, to live righteously, to live a godly life in this present age, in this dark moment. We need this grace, Church of Jesus. Eladia masada bahanda lababuria. This grace that enables a man to say no to ungodly things. This grace that enables a man to live a righteous life. Edabahanda. Edabia sanda bagadeba solabahanda. Eladia masanda lalaya dabasilia. This grace that enables a man to say no to sin. This grace will teach us how to deny ungodly things. This grace is present. The grace for righteousness. Eladia masanda bahanda bosalianda. In this present age, neema inayofundisha watu kusema la kwa mambo ya mwili, kwa mambo ya dunia, kusema la
Halia sakata bahanda. Ni neema, neema diyo mwalimu wetu. Katika jina la Yesu. This grace has appeared to every one of us. This grace is present tonight. The grace saladosa hande. Elanaya talamaya karamaya kalaba. Take it deeper for another one moment. The grace of God, 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 the grace of God. Irabuhanda rabayanda, rimama mayanda rababeri bahanda rababuria. We give you glory, Master. Haleda shadagara. Thank you for your grace tonight. Thank you for your grace tonight. Thank you for your grace tonight. We worship you. We give you glory. We give you honor. Come on, put your hands together and celebrate the grace of God. Celebrate the grace of God. The grace of God. Celebrate, celebrate, celebrate the grace of God. God bless you. Let us appreciate our praise team. God bless you in the name of Jesus, even as we take our blessed seats in the presence of God under this mighty grace that enables men to say no to ungodly things, to unrighteousness. It is the grace, the grace, the grace of God. Ningeshukuru, ningependa kuchukua nafasi hii kumshukuru Mungu kwa sababu ya kunipa neema kusimama mbele zenu na kuwaletea neno la Mungu jioni ya siku leo. Pia ninaheshimu neema ya Mungu iliyo juu ya wazazi wetu wa kiroho mahali hapa. Our Reverend and our Mom, I appreciate and I honor that grace. Help me to appreciate the grace of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Ninashukuru kwa ajili ya kupata hii fursa na nafasi. Pia ninashukuru kwa ajili ya nyinyi wote ambao mumetenga nafasi yenu mkaingia katika ibada ya jioni ya siku ya leo. Bwana wabariki katika jina la Yesu. Ombi langu ni kwamba may you be satisfied tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Say amen. Straight to the word of God and to the theme of this week: hunger for righteousness that results in kingdom works. Njaa ya haki. Baada ya hii njaa ya haki inasababisha sisi kuingia katika kazi ya ufalme katika jina la Yesu. Sema amina. So there are three words here I'll be speaking about tonight. There is the hunger, there is the righteousness, and kingdom works. Hunger, righteousness, and kingdom works. When we speak about hunger, this is all I have to say about hunger. That your level of hunger determines your degree of satisfaction in God. Your level of hunger determines your degree of satisfaction in God. That is all about hunger. Number two point about hunger is that you are what you eat. You are what you eat. You are what you eat. Now, madaktari wa lishe bora wanatuambia our appetite determines our diet and our diet determines our intake and our intake determines our health. I will come again. Madaktari wa lishe bora wanatuambia our appetite determines our diet and our diet determines our intake and our intake determines our health. Praise the Lord. Na diposa tukasema kwamba you are what you eat. And as it is in physical, the same it is in spiritual. Na diposa tumekuwa na hayo maandiko. In the book of Matthew chapter number 5, verses number 6. And here Jesus tells us that our hunger determines our spiritual health. Our hunger in this scripture, that is Matthew chapter number 5, verses number 6. Our hunger determines our spiritual health. So that is all I have to say about hunger. Number two, righteousness. About righteousness, we can say that righteousness is a gift from God. Righteousness is a gift from God. And therefore, we must appreciate the gift of spiritual hunger in the name of Jesus Christ. And righteousness, there is the righteousness and holiness. Hayo ni maneno mawili ambayo ni tofauti. When we speak about righteousness, it is a state of position. And when we speak about holiness, it is a state of character. So righteousness, it is the state of position. Holiness, it is the state of character. Amen. Glory to God. Number three, kingdom work. Kingdom work. And in this house, we know that our motto is excellent kingdom service. Praise the Lord. So when we speak about kingdom work, we speak about excellent kingdom service. Say excellent kingdom service. Amen. I'm just sharing a few nuggets. Then we venture into the scriptures. We preach, and our God will be manifested in this place. So about the kingdom, in the kingdom of God, we only receive what we hunger and thirst for. In the kingdom of God, we only receive what we hunger and thirst for. Katika ufalme huu, tunapokea kile ambacho tuko na njaa na kiu ya hicho kitu katika jina la Yesu. Number two we can see about the kingdom is God responds to us in proportion to our spiritual appetite. Hallelujah. God responds to us in proportion to our spiritual appetite. And at that point, we can say is, those who desire God passionately receive spiritual reward that have tangible results. Watu ambao wako na shauku, na njaa kubwa na hamu ya Mungu, watu ambao wanatamani Mungu kwa njia ambayo ni tofauti, huwa wanapata thawabu ama wanapata taji ya vitu ambavyo vinaonekana na hata vinaweza shikika kwa mikono. Jina la Bwana linoliwe. So we will see fruitfulness, we will see growth, we will see expansion. Praise the Lord. To those people who are seriously have the hunger for the things of God. Now to the word of God. Amos chapter number 8, verses number 11 in Amplified. That is all about hunger, righteousness, and kingdom work. Amos chapter number 8, verses number 11. Let us read together, Church of Jesus. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord God, when I will send a famine in the land. there a famine, we can say, I will send a hunger in the land. Not a famine of bread, not a hunger for bread, nor a thirst for water, but a famine for hearing the words of the Lord God. Praise the Lord. This is the prophet of God who is speaking these words, that days are coming, and we are in those days. And it is my prayer that even this scripture will be fulfilled in this house, that people will be full of the hunger, the thirst for the word of God. Praise the Lord. Because if we connect this scripture, the hunger, the famine for the word of God, the famine for hearing the word of God, tunakimbia kwa sababu dani yetu tumejawa na shauku, dani yetu kumejawa na kiu, dani yetu kumejawa na njaa. Na sio njaa ya maji ama chakula, lakini ni njaa ya kutamani kusikia neno la Mungu. Na wakati hii njaa imepata mtu, ni nini hicho ambacho kinatokea katika maisha ya mwanadamu? Let us connect with John chapter number 15, verses number 3. We see hunger for hearing the words of God. Shikiria hapo. We connect this scripture. John chapter number 15, verses 3. This is Jesus Christ. Let us read together. You are cleansed and pruned already because of the word which I have given you. The word, the teachings I have discussed with you. A post there. You are cleansed. We are speaking about righteousness. Praise the Lord. And righteousness is all about being cleansed. Praise the Lord. And now Jesus is saying, you are cleansed and pruned already because of the word which I have given you, the teachings I have discussed with you. And in Amos, the word of God says, there will be a famine. The desire, the famine for hearing the word of God. And the result of hearing the word of God is righteousness. The result, wherever we come in the house of God, we sit down and we listen to the preaching and to the word of God. What happens to us? It is the process of cleansing. Praise the Lord. And that results to righteousness. Praise the Lord. So Jesus is saying, you are cleansed. You are pruned already because of the word that I have spoken to you. Praise the Lord. So wakati tunapoingia katika nyumba ya Mungu na tunaketi chini tunaanza kusikia neno la Bwana, kile ambacho kinafanyika, tunasafishwa, tunakuwa safi, tunazidi kugeuzwa ili tukae kama Mungu wetu. Praise the Lord. And this is why it is very key, hunger and righteousness. That hunger will be released to us, that we shall run to the place where the word of God is being preached in the name of Jesus Christ for nourishment. Say amen. Let's connect with 1 Peter chapter number 2, verses 2 and 3. This is a result. Fruitfulness. Or before you go to 1 Peter, give me verse 16. John 15:16. The results of after being cleansed, the results after being righteous, the result. You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you, that I have appointed you, I have planted you, that you might go and bear fruit, and keep on bearing, and that your fruit may be lasting, that it may remain, abide, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, as presenting all that I am, he may give you the fruit that will remain. The fruit, the result now, after being cleansed, baada ya kusafishwa, matokeo yanayotokea ni matunda, na ni matunda ambayo yatabaki katika jina la Yesu. Praise the Lord. 1 Peter 2. We build something then. Haladosha. 1 Peter chapter 2 verses 2 and 3. Yes. Let us read together. Like newborn babies, you should crave, thirst for, earnestly desire the pure spiritual milk, that by it you may be nurtured and grow. We say the result, there is growth after cleansing, after righteousness. When you live that life, that righteousness, that righteous life, there is the result of fruitfulness, the result of growth. And here it says, growth and to completed salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. So that is the process. In order for us to have the results, to have the results in the kingdom work, to produce evidence in this kingdom work, before there is the cleansing. That is the point of righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. Blessings of having hunger for righteousness. Or the rewards. Blessing. There are many. I'll just mention one. Psalms chapter number 45, verses number 7. This is the blessing. And I pray and I desire that this portion of scripture will be our portion tonight. Psalms 45, verses 7. Let us read together. You love righteousness, uprightness, and right standing with God. The definition of righteousness, we were told yesterday, and God bless everyone ambaye ametangulia kutoka Monday na siku ya jana, maana ninajenga juu ya huu msingi katika jina la Yesu. Mungu uzima wabariki. Now, the definition of righteousness, tulielezewa. The word of God says, let us read it together. 1, 2, 3, go. You love righteousness, uprightness, and right standing with God, and hate wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows. Say amen. This is the reward. This is the blessing of righteousness. Praise the Lord. And it means you hate wickedness. And if you hate wickedness, it means you hate what God hates. And you love what God loves. And God loves righteousness. And because you have made your mind to love righteousness and to hate wickedness, there is a great reward in the name of Jesus Christ. And the reward is Therefore your God has anointed you with oil of gladness above your fellows. Another version says, above your companions, above your competitors. Praise the Lord. So if you desire to stand out, love righteousness in the name of Jesus, even in your workplace, even in your career, even in business, even in ministry, if you desire to shine and to stand out, love righteousness and hate wickedness, and the oil will be upon you in the name of Jesus. Say amen. Praise the Lord. May the Lord help us to love righteousness. Say amen. May the Lord help us to hate wickedness. Say amen. And may the Lord, Jehovah God, the anointer of men, may he anoint us even tonight with the oil of gladness, even above our competitors, even above our companions, even above our fellows. Say amen. Connect us with Malachi, chapter number 3, verses 18. Katushe kapata. Halada serabagadaba sagadagaria. Glory to God. Malachi. Let us connect that scripture. We flow. Thank you. Let us read together. Then shall you return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him who serves God and him. Make it louder. Give us the version that has distinction. There must be a mark of distinction between the righteous and the wicked, between those who love God and those who do not love God. So it is upon us tonight. We make our minds up that we shall love righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. I have remembered even a scripture that says, righteousness exalts a nation, and sin is a reproach to every nation. You desire to be exalted. You desire to be lifted. You desire to be promoted. Love righteousness in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of God has promised us that there will be a mark of distinction between the righteous and the wicked in the name of Jesus Christ. Say amen. Glory to God in the highest. It is becoming sweeter and sweeter. Psalms 107 verses number 9. Glory to God. Hallada Shiriga. Hunger for righteousness that results in kingdom works. NIV, perfect. Thank you. Let us read together, Church of Jesus. 1, 2, 3, go. For he satisfies the thirst and fills the hungry with good things. Say good things. Mara nyingi tunasema, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Now this is the key point. If you love righteousness and hate wickedness, this is a promise that he will satisfy the thirsty and fills the hungry with good things. Say good things. Everything that you desire. That's why we say our God has a plan for us. Good plan. These are the goodies, goodies, goodies in the name of Jesus Christ. But the secret is love righteousness, to hate wickedness in the name of Jesus Christ. Hata ukiona kama wengine wanaofanya dhambi,
na wanatenda dhambi na wako kwa dhambi, unaona kana kwamba wanafanikiwa. Usidanganyike katika jina la Yesu. Yako jua yako ni tofauti. Kufanikiwa kwako, your goodies are in the house of God. That's why we are saying flourishing in his courts. Praise the Lord. The goodies in the name of Jesus Christ. He satisfies a longing soul. Whoever is longing for him, he satisfies him in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us go to the point of the Holy Spirit. John chapter number 7, verses 37. This is so sweet. Lena naya kasatoko siliada. Amplified is okay with that scripture. John chapter number 7, verses 37 through verse 39. The praise of the Holy Spirit in righteousness, in hunger, and in kingdom works. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us read together this portion of scripture. 1, 2, 3, go. Now, on the final and most important day of the feast, Jesus stood and he cried in a loud voice, "If any man is thirst, let him come to me and drink." Ask your neighbor, are you thirst tonight? Are you thirst tonight? Muulize kama kona kiu. Muulize je ukona kiu jioni ya leo. Ikiwa kona kiu, atashibishwa katika jina la Yesu. That AD says, 1, 2, 3, go, make it louder and better. He who believes in me, he who believes in me, who cleaves to and trust in and relies on me, as the scripture has said, from his innermost being shall flow continuously springs and rivers of living water. Praise the Lord. Who you are lianakiu? Yeyote ako na kiu na aje kwangu. Aniaminie mimi kama vile maandiko yalivyonena. Mito ya maji yaliyo hai itatoka ndani yake. Jina la Bwana liinuliwe. Baada ya kukuja na kiu, kuna mahali pa kushibishwa. Kuna mahali pa kuondolewa kiu. Na ukisha ingia mahali pale, kiu chako kinabadilishwa. Sasa kunaanza kutoka kitu ndani yako. Katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Maana mahali popote mto ulipitia, mto wa Roho Mtakatifu, ikiwa apakwa na uhai, palipata uhai katika jina la Yesu. Sema amina. Mito ya tililika, mito ya Roho Mtakatifu, mito inabeba uzima, mito inabeba uponyaji, mito imebeba kila kitu ambacho unachotamani katika jina la Yesu. Let's see this river, 39. But, make it louder, he was speaking here of the Spirit, whom those who believed, those who trusted, those who had faith in him, were afterward to receive. For the Holy Spirit had not yet been given, because Jesus was not yet glorified, raised, and honored. Let us connect. Shikilia hiyo. Whoever believes in me, rivers of living water shall flow. Connect us with John chapter number 14. Now we go to the works. This is now the Holy Spirit. John 14, verses 12 through verses 18. New King James Version. John.
Whoever believes in me, yes. You're reading through verse 18. Halada sadagada. Mashadagaria. Let us read together, church. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me. Pause. The first scripture was, he who believes in me, rivers of living water will flow from within him. Ah, the Holy Spirit. Now here comes. He who believes in me, what will happen to him? The works that I do. This is Jesus Christ speaking. The works that I do, he will do also. That is first point. That the works that Jesus did, you will do also. First level. The next level. Make it louder and better. And greater works than these he will do. Because I go to my Father. Praise the Lord. Say greater works. Say greater works. Say greater works. Halado shirigada. Verses 13. And whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. Proceed 14. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. 15. If you love me, keep my commandment. If you love me, keep my commandment. If you love me, keep my commandment. 16. Make it louder. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper that he may abide with you forever. Praise the Lord. The helper here is the Holy Spirit. 17. Make it louder. The Spirit of truth, whom the world, the wicked, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him, but you know him, for he dwells with you and will be in you. Praise the Lord. Say, he dwells with me and he will be in me. 18. I will not leave you orphans. I will come to you. Praise the Lord. This is so sweet. Whoever believes in me, whoever believes in me, number one, will also do works that I do, and greater works than those will he do. Number one. Number two, Jesus says, whoever believes in me, out of him will flow rivers of living water. Praise the Lord. Also, Jesus says, whoever believes in me shall never thirst. Hivyo ndivyo aliambia mwanamke Msamaria. Also, Jesus says, whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall live. Jesus also said, whoever believes in me will not remain in darkness. Jesus also says, whoever believes in me shall not perish. Jesus also says, whoever believes in me has eternal life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Ili tuweze kuishi maisha ya haki, maisha ya uteua, maisha ya kuheshimisha na kutukuza Mungu, lazima tuwe tumepokea msaidizi. Msaidizi ni Roho Mtakatifu. Jina la Bwana liinuliwe. Hawezi kuishi maisha ya uteua, maisha ya kumtukuza Bwana, pasipo ujazo wa Roho Mtakatifu. Jambo la pili, matendo ya ufalme ama kazi ya ufalme hauwezi kuitenda na kufanya pasipo msaidizi ambaye ni Roho Mtakatifu. Halagada basekaragada. He is the secret for us to live a righteous life and to do the kingdom works. Even greater, it is secret, the Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. The word of God says, Abraham, that is Genesis 15:6, that Abraham believed the Lord and he counted it to him as righteousness. Praise the Lord. Whoever believes in me, Abraham believed in God. It was counted. Another version says, it was credited into his account righteousness. Praise the Lord. Believing in Jesus Christ. Ask your neighbor, do you believe in Jesus? Hallelujah. Tusimame tunapobarikia. The Holy Spirit, Elada Shagara, he is the secret, he is our helper. Yedi atatuwezesha hayo mambo mawili. Atatuwezesha kuishi maisha ya uteua. He is holy. He is holy. He is called the Holy Spirit. Kwa hivyo anakuja mahali patakatifu. Diposa anaitwa Roho Mtakatifu. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. A righteous person, a righteous vessel, a clean vessel for the space of the Holy Spirit. Halagarebo shakadaba. Tunapomalizia ili tuombe. Halagarebo. Luke chapter number 1 verses 53 in Amplified. Heladaya sarabagadia. Holy Spirit, we need you. Heladia masalagadia masalagadia. Helamia salabagadia masagada. Hunger for righteousness that results in kingdom service. Yes, here we go. In takasakatapa, alluded scripture. Let it be our portion tonight. In the name of Jesus Christ. Make it louder. In the name of Jesus Christ. He has filled and satisfied the hungry with good things. And the rich he has sent away empty-handed without a gift. Halada seda garibu sada. Jisome yo mandiko na uyatafakali jinsi anavyo sema. Halida basara gariba sara bagida. He satisfied the hungry. He fills them. And the rich, usi ule utajiri wa mali, ni utajiri watu wa, you know, in that book of Matthew, chapter number 5, verses 3, it says, blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Are you rich spiritually, or are you poor spiritually? Do you need to be satisfied tonight? Are you hungry for God tonight? If you are rich, you will go away. You will go back home empty-handed. That is what the scripture is saying. But if you are hungry, you are thirst, you will be filled, you will be satisfied in the name of Jesus Christ. It is my humble prayer and desire that no one of us will go home empty-handed without a gift in the name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and tell the Holy Spirit, I am hungry for you. I am thirst. Satisfy me, Holy Spirit. Satisfy me, Holy Spirit. Fill me, Holy Spirit. Alada sadagada busada. Ya kwamba hakuna moja wetu atatumwa tutarejea nyumbani mikono mitupu katika jina la Yesu. Mwimbaji akaimba akasema, I receive my miracle today. I refuse to go back empty-handed in the name of Jesus. Herena shandala baburia bakaya dabosa gadaba. Holy Spirit of God, fill me. Holy Spirit of God, satisfy me. Holy Spirit of God, I am poor. Elanaya salabaya karabaya kusele bagada. Halia sata kosa dagadia masadagadia masadagada. Elania masela makata la bakata busaka. Mimi ni maskini wa kiroho baba katishu takasa. Nina kuitaji jioni ya leo. Uweze kunishibisha. Mito ya maji Bwana. Ikatoke ndani mwangu kapaya tana ya kasada. Inama ya kataba sada baraba ya tana mayada. I am a vessel that needs you. Holy Spirit, alaya kusata bahata kusada. Purge me, sanctify me, purify me, cleanse me. Fill me, satisfy me tonight, Holy Spirit. Elnanaya karama ya kusere mahandara baburia. Ele mamama ya takusata bagada. So that God, I'll walk before thee blameless. And upright before thee, Masaka Dabagada. Eli Labai Labai Sadagada. Eli Masanda Lababeria Masadabala Busagada. Satisfy us tonight. Satisfy us tonight. Holy Spirit of God. Eli Labai Labai Sada. Eli Labai Sadaya Rababeria. Satisfy us, Alagayada. Naradu Shiri Bagada Basura Bagada. Elai Rabai Rabai Yasula Bagada. Satisfy us tonight, Holy Spirit. Fill us tonight. Elada Bushalaga.
Jesus, you're worthy. You're worthy, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. It's all about you this hour. We exalt you, dear Lord Jesus. We have come hungry, desiring that you are going to fill our hungry souls with thy righteousness, O God, with good things that come from you. The Bible says that every good and perfect gift comes from above, and you will satisfy us with every good thing that comes from above, O God, and our souls are going to be refreshed in you. You alone knoweth the hunger in our souls. You alone knoweth what is best for us. And my God, that is why we submit, desiring that which is of perfect refreshment to our souls and spirits tonight. You are going to pour on us in abundance. In the name of Jesus Christ, open the floodgates of heaven, Lord, and pour on us. In the name of Jesus, rain of the season, we pray. In the name of Jesus, rain for the season. We worship you, Jehovah. We surrender to you this hour. Have your way in our hearts. Have your way in our hearts. Again, Lord, we pray that which every one of us in your presence needs. Bible says, and you have spoken to us, that whatsoever we shall ask in your name, we shall receive it. And every need, every desire, everything that we have come loaded with, we want to lift everything and ask of your name that you are going to set us free from this place by receiving that which we need in the name of Jesus. We have prayed in thy name because we know that everything we shall ask in your name, we shall receive. Thank you for cleansing us in your word. And in your righteousness, O God, you shall make us stand. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, we worship your name. For you are God, and besides thee, there is no other one. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and believe. Let the church say amen. Amen, amen, amen. Glory to God. Amen. As we conclude, Isaiah 55:1, as you turn to your neighbor, Mwambie, we pray. Turn to your neighbor, Mwambie, we pray, we believe, we receive, and we have it for good.
Repeat that in Jesus' name. We pray, huh? Some have said we receive twice. We say we pray, we believe, we receive, and have it for good. That is very biblical in the book of Mark in Jesus' mighty name. Yes. The Bible says that wait and listen. Everyone who is thirsty, come to me, to the waters, and he who has no money, come and buy and eat. Yes, come buy priceless spiritual wine and milk without money and without price, simply for the self-surrender that accept the blessing. Praise be to God. The Lord bless you because you have come in the name of Jesus. Now, I want us to give us a way of worship to our God. I know there are so many theories about giving, but today I just want you to give us a way of worshiping and acknowledging the hand of God. Praise the Lord. Whatever the Lord, the measure he has given you, the blessing he has poured upon you, and to that measure, God is going to bless you. So as we stretch our hands to him, I know God is going to come back with an even higher blessing in the name of Jesus. Now, I heard someone saying somewhere, Kwamba, if you allow God to get into your pocket, he will allow you to get into his pocket. And when you get in the pocket of the Lord, you're not going to find coins. Bwana asifiwe. So allow God to get into your pocket, and he will allow you to get into his. And when you get into his pocket, you are not going to find what? Praise the Lord. You are going to find gold, silver, and that is the best measure. That one is not affected by inflation. Dollar is affected by inflation, whichever the currency, even the pound, all of them can be affected by inflation. But gold, what you find in the Lord, you cannot find it in inflation. So if you are giving online, the Lord bless you. So I want us to stand. And if you are giving physically, just come. Just come. As we sing this chorus in Jesus' name. That says there is power in the blood. You know, we are still meditating about the righteousness of God.
Power in the blood. Power in the blood. There is power. Power. Wonder working power. In the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder working power in the blood of the Lord. There is power, power, wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. There is power, Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost in the blood, precious blood. If there is power, Holy Ghost, power in the precious blood. One more time, there is power, power, Holy Ghost. In the blood of the Lamb, there is Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, and our King power in the precious blood of the Lord.
Amen. Now turn to your neighbor, you bless him or her with these words in Jesus' mighty name. May the Lord go before you. May the Lord give you victory. May the fragrance of the Lord be upon you. May the Lord shine his countenance on you. May he go before you to break every bar gate ahead of you. May the Lord give you companion And may you manifest the power of the Lord. May you walk in prosperity, in victory, in Jesus' mighty name. And surely goodness and mercy, and may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, and forevermore. Shalom, shalom. The Lord bless you.